Okay, so today we want to talk about operations with functions, and this is from section 2.1 or 1.2. One of those sections, I think it's 1.2. And we're going to talk about operations with functions. In this video, we'll talk about addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And then in the next couple videos, I'll talk about compositions. So, and really, operations with functions, you might not even think that we need to talk about addition, subtraction, and those things. They do work pretty close to how you think they would. So in mathematics, we have this idea of adding two functions together, f plus g of x. And that is really the same and defined to be f of x plus g of x. When I want to subtract g from f, f minus g of x, it's f of x minus g of x. When I want to multiply two functions, I get fg of x is f of x times g of x. And when I want to divide, f divided by g, all of x, I get f of x divided by g of x. So they really are defined in the way that you might think they are. Here, we want to exclude g of x from being identically the zero function. Okay, so I just want to do a couple of quick examples to show you how this kind of works. So let's get a couple of functions. F of x is equal to 2 plus 3x, and g of x is equal to x squared minus 1. And I just want to find f minus g of x. Okay? And we just saw that this was f of x minus g of x, which is 2 plus 3x. That piece minus x squared minus 1. I put those in parentheses to keep track of minus signs. And then I am going to go ahead and distribute those, that minus to the piece that follows to the x squared minus 1. So I'll write out 2 plus 3x minus x squared plus 1. And that gives me a negative x squared plus 3x plus 3. And that's my function, f minus g of x. So you can kind of see it works like you think it should work. You plug in these functions. Now I will make a note for the functions above. I want to find, let's say, f times g of 2. Now, I could find f times g of x. That's one place to start. Maybe I'll show you guys this. So, method one here is find f times g of x. So let's find that. I'll put 2 plus 3x. Oops, let me put in the f of x times g of x. F of x times g of x, right? And then I'll plug in the actual formulas. 2 plus 3x times x squared minus 1. And then you can FOIL this out. 2x squared minus 2 plus 3x cubed minus 3x. And I would probably really write that 3x cubed plus 2x squared minus 3x minus 2. And then I want, and so that's my function, fg of x, and then I get fg g of 2 by plugging 2 into that function. 3 times 2 cubed plus 2 times 2 squared minus 3 times 2 minus 2. Let me plug all of that into my actual function and we'll get an answer. And you guys please check what I'm doing, but I get fg of 2 is 24, okay? The other method, method 2, is for me to find f of 2 and then g of 2. So let me find f of 2 first. That's 2 plus 3x, which is 2 plus 3 times 2, which should be, I think, 8, right? 3 times 2 is 6, plus 2 is 8. G of 2 is equal to, and g of x is x squared minus 1, so I put in 2 where there's an x. I get 4 squared minus 1 is 3. So f g of 2 is f of 2 times g of 2, so I get 8 times 3, 24. So it's kind of up to your preference and what information you have. If you already computed fg, the product, then maybe you just want to use that formula. Maybe it's easier to just plug into the individual pieces. But that's kind of an overview of addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. They do work the way that you think that they will. Okay, so let me know if you guys have questions about that.